is, it's not going to be a Roomba which just does reflexive actions. It will actually need to model the humans in the loop. You need to understand what the human is trying to do so that you can help them. Once again, here is something that I'm sure the dean will know, but none of you will know. There used to be a great show called MASH on the TV, okay? And there was a guy called Radar in MASH. Radar is an amazing guy because before his boss figures out what he needs, Radar knows and gives it to him. So I have written lots of proposals saying I'm going to make Radar, and they keep giving me money. Why? Because everybody wants a Radar. Okay, and, but the Radar was able to do it because he was able to model the beliefs, desires, intentions of his boss. Otherwise, he couldn't have done it. Okay? And then the last one was, could we give AI the feeling of curiosity, leading them to have desires for physical things? Curiosity, yes. It turns out that this whole entire area of reinforcement learning, where there are two issues. This is probably the last big thing I'll say, and then you can leave. At any given point of time, you have some knowledge. You can use that knowledge to exploit that knowledge to decide what action to do. You can also try to get more knowledge. All you losers here who are going to college have decided that, right? Instead of getting a nice job in McDonald's, you've decided to come to college. You've decided somehow that increasing your knowledge is helpful. That is always this question. At some point of time, if you continue to be in the college for 25 more years, I'm sure it will start becoming irrational. But right now, I certainly believe, and most of you I'm sure believe, that it's a rational thing to do. Because the optimal decision with an incomplete model of the world can be arbitrarily far from even a suboptimal decision with a complete, more complete model of the world. How do you get more complete model of the world? That's how you do that, by exploration. So rather than just getting to the class, you stop and, you know, basically smell roses or look around, what does this byway in this college lead to, or what does this particular talk tell me about? And that's all exploration. You showed up here because you're exploring. Okay, and it turns out there's a very nice mathematical way of capturing this exploration versus trade-offs in reinforcement learning. So this little picture basically is saying, if I don't know at all that these things exist in the world, and this is a grid world, I only know these things exist. That's possible, right? I right now know that Barrett's College has two buildings, because those are the only two buildings I saw just now when I came. Now, if I'm trying to optimize only with this and I need to reach this, I might think this is the best way to go.